Hi, this is Graham. Hope everyone's having a great day. In today's video, I'd like to show you how to clean the sensor in a Panasonic Lumix compact camera. The sensor gets full of dust or pollen due to the fact that when the camera extends in its initialization mode, the action of the lens moving out causes air to be sucked in through any aperture in the camera, maybe through the background, the screen, or in fact around the lens itself. So if you're storing this camera in your pocket, where the dust does collect around the inside ridges of the lens, then when you extend the camera, that dust gets sucked into the lens itself. The most likely culprit is going to be the infrared filter, which is placed in front of the CCD element. But to gain access to that, you need to split the camera to gain access to the back of the lens. In this video, I'm going to show you how to split this camera and clean the sensor and the infrared filter. But you must be aware that you can damage a camera if you attempt this without the requisite skills. Okay, so we're going to start to disassemble this camera, but you'll need some specialist tools. The first thing you'll need is a number 0 crosspoint jeweler screwdriver. Optionally, you'll need a pair of tweezers to handle the small screws, but they're not absolutely essential, but they do help. To actually clean the sensor and the infrared filter, I prefer to use these cotton wool buds, or you can use lens tissue or a lint-free lens cloth. Ideally, you should have a container to put the screws in, and you can work in a logical manner. So if you take the screws out from the right-hand side of the camera and place them in the right side of the container, you know that when you reinstall the screws in the camera, you're putting the right screws in the right holes. So let's start by disassembling this camera. And it's a TZ10, which has got sensor problems with dust. And we need to remove the rear of the camera to gain access to the CCD block. To remove the TZ10 rear case, you need to remove 2 screws from the right-hand side, 3 screws from the base, and 4 screws from the left-hand side. To remove the screws, it's just a simple matter of using your jeweler screwdriver, pressing hard into the screw so you don't slip and damage the screw head, and then undo the screw and place it into your container. So I'll go ahead and remove the 6 screws now, and I'll join in a moment. So now I've removed the case screws, we can remove the rear of the camera. In this particular camera, the LCD screen is fitted to the inside of the rear camera case, and the LCD is attached to the camera through ribbon cables. So when we start to split the camera, it's important that you don't pull the camera case up directly without freeing the ribbon cables from the clips. So once we remove the case, we can see now that inside the camera, we have the 2 ribbon cables which connect the LCD to the printed circuit board of the camera. The ribbon cables are held in connectors via some friction locks, and you have to release those locks by using a small screwdriver or your tweezers just to lift up the black locking lever from each of the connectors. Then you can just gently pull the ribbon cables from those connectors and remove the complete rear of the camera case. Now in this particular camera, the actual CCD block is underneath this back plate, and so we have to remove this back plate to gain access to it. In this case, there are just 3 screws which hold this plate in place. So keeping those 3 screws separate, because they are a different thread to the camera body thread screws. And just observe how the plate comes off. In this particular case, there's a small clip at the bottom of the camera and one at the side to be released before the actual plate will come off. And then you can just remove the plate from the camera. That now gives you access to the CCD block itself. The CCD is mounted on the back of the lens with just 3 screws. I prefer to release the CCD so I can gain access to the lens of the camera as well, so I can give that a clean. So it's like the LCD connector, it's just a friction lock, which again released by flicking up the black lever and then just teasing out the ribbon cable. So to remove the CCD block, we just need to remove these three screws from the rear of the block. Depending on how long this has been in the camera, sometimes the CCD comes out with the infrared filter attached, and other times the infrared filter stays within the lens assembly. But in either case, it's easy to remove. So remove these three screws, and again keeping the three screws separate. And now we can gently remove the CCD block for cleaning. So in this case, there's the CCD, and left within the camera is the infrared filter in a small plastic boot. So if I place this on a piece of lens tissue, you can see the infrared filter has a cyan appearance, and it's the cyan filter which is the component which will stop the infrared light affecting the sensor. This is the most likely culprit for gathering dust, as it's the first element within the camera that the dust can access. To clean that, I would use my cotton wool buds and just gently wipe the surface of the infrared filter. It's unlikely dust gets into the inside because it's protected by this rubber gasket. Similarly with the CCD sensor, it's unlikely that dust has got as far as the CCD sensor, but while it's apart, it's worth just giving that a quick wipe. Now we can reassemble the CCD into the lens block, but before we do that, it's worth pointing out that here is the focus element of the lens. So it's this area as well which is likely to gather dust, but unfortunately we can only access the rear surface of the lens. To actually gain access to the front surface means taking out the lens assembly and completely stripping the lens to get there, which is probably beyond your expertise. So just to clear the rear surface of that with your cotton wool bud, just to gently wipe over the area that you can gain access to, will remove any dust. And now we want to reassemble the infrared filter and the CCD. So if we take the infrared filter in its gasket and we place it back into the camera so that the gasket faces upwards and seals the CCD, and then replace the CCD, and it's mounted on two little plastic pegs. So once you have the CCD lined up on the plastic pegs, it is completely aligned with the lens. So now it's just a case of inserting our three screws, and it's best to do these one at a time and just gently tighten that screw down, but not all the way, just to hold it in position. And now we insert the next screw. And finally the third screw. Now you've got them gently tightened down, you can go around the three of the screws, tightening it down a little more securely, but not forcefully. So you're just tightening down the screw onto the plastic mount. Now we can insert the data cable from the CCD back to the camera in its quick release socket. So push it hard into the base and then lock down the locking lever. Give the back of the CCD a wipe to make it clear of fingerprints. And now we can reinstall the rear plate from the camera. Insert the three screws which belong to that. Okay, so now we can install the rear of the camera and connect the LCD data and backlight connector. So if we just push the connectors back into the connector block, push them hard as far as it will go, and then close the latch, and the same with the backlight connector. Place that in its socket and close down the latch. Can now reinstall the case and fit the case screws. Get the screen away, and the camera is now ready for testing again. So that's the process for the disassembly of the camera, the cleaning of the CCD and infrared filter, and the subsequent reassembly of the camera. Most of the Panasonic cameras follow the same idea with regards to removal of the case and a backplate to gain access to the CCD. Most of the CCDs are fixed with three screws, and the majority of them are fixed with Phillips head or cross-point screws. A very small majority might have the very small torque screws, but I've only come across those in two particular cameras. So providing that you take care in removing the camera back as to not damage the ribbon cables, and providing that you work in a sensible manner, there's no reason why you can't attempt the sensor clean yourself and save yourself a few pounds at the local repair shop. Okay, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and as usual, please rate, comment and subscribe. So that's Graham saying thanks for watching. Bye for now.